The method to calculate directions in a unit cell, therefore directions in a crystal structure, will be shown in this video for four vectors in the unit cell. So indicated with arrows the directions are interested in, and we'll go through each of them to determine the notation. So we'll start off with the green line. So I've indicated X, Y, and Z directions, and so the unit cell in general, which is going to have A, B, and C indicating the dimensions of each of those directions. This is cube, of course, they're the same values, but let's just look in a general case. And so when I'm interested in this direction A, I'm going to make this end of the arrow, the origin, and then look at the three axes and what the projection is on that axis in terms of the unit cell dimension. So for the x-axis, we're at the origin, so that would be 0. For the y-axis, we're 1/2 of the dimension b. So from here to here, that distance is b, so this is 1/2 of b. And for the z-axis, where projection is 1 of c, the dimension in the z-direction. So then to create, so this is 0 times a, we first say 0, 1/2, and 1, removing a, b, and c. We then make them all integers, so 0, 1, and 2. And then our direction would be 0, 1, 2. So just the x, y, and z vector projection. So this is the direction for A, the green line. So we can look at additional curves and do the same thing. So for B, I'm going to make this the origin, and we're going to look at the x-axis, the y, and the z-axis. And for the x-axis, we're going in a positive direction, right? So positive is this way on the x-axis, 1/2 of A, we're starting here, we're going to here, so the projection, 1/2 of A. Y-axis is also the y-axis, however, is negative, right? And its entire projection would be entire unit cell length B, so this is 1 times B, and then the z-axis is 1/2, and the dimension in the z-direction, the unit cell is C. So again, 1/2, 1, and 1/2, making them all integers, 1, 2, 1, but, sorry, left off, this is minus. And so now I have the unit cell, the direction from the unit cell, but I don't write minus 2. Instead, I write 2 with the minus sign. So for line B, this is the direction. For line C, we'll pick this as the origin, and then we'll look at A, we're going negative, and projection, it's minus 1 for the x direction times A. Y direction, it's positive 1 times B dimension. And Z, this is the origin, and Z is 0 times C. It's minus 1, 1, 0 direction. We put the minus sign here. So this is the direction, and this is for line C, or direction C in the unit cell. And finally, we'll look at D, where now D is starting here. So here is our origin. And now this is hitting the face. So it's hitting this face in the center. So our x direction is halfway, 1/2 of A. The y direction is 1 times B. And the z direction is 1/2 times C. So the 1/2, 1, 1/2 are the numbers. Making them integers, 1, 2, 1. So 1, 2, 1 is direction for D. So line D with the arrow pointing this way has this notation for its direction.